ஸ்ரீ குருபியோ நமக ஐ ஆம் ஹாப்பி டு வெல்கம் யூ ஆல் ஃபார் அவர் ஆன்லைன் டீச்சிங் அகாடமி ஏ கலைவா ஃபார் த கிளாஸ் 8 சப்ஜெக்ட் கெமிஸ்ட்ரி யூனிட் 10 சேஞ்சஸ் அரவுண்ட் அஸ் டுடே வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு டிஸ்கஸ் அபவுட் த நியூ லெசன் இன் கெமிஸ்ட்ரி சேஞ்சஸ் அரவுண்ட் அஸ் Before going to start the lesson, the first one is introduction. Have you ever visited Kudipinar in Delhi, children? Anyone? Yes. There you can see a rust-resistant iron pillar. It was constructed before 1500 years ago. That particular iron resistant pillar will not become rust, it will not conduct any rust, it will not conduct, it will not happen any rust. But not all the things are unchanged like this. Many of the things surround us may have a chance of changing frequently. Okay, so except a few are unchangeable, many of the matter around us are changeable. So not at all the things are unchangeable like this. Many of this we can see in our life are changing. You could have noticed a milk turning into curd. So what happens there? The bacteria, lactobacillus bacteria, acted on the milk, it converts the milk into curd. That is also one of the changes takes place. Okay, so you could have noticed milk changing into curd. We see number of changes in our surroundings. We see number of changings in and around us. Okay, so some of them are physical changes and some of them are chemical changes. See children, physical changes in matter cut, tear, folded, written on, painted, all these are physical change. You have a notebook in your hand, right? On that notebook you are writing something. So before writing, that notebook is empty. After that you are writing something, means that notebook have the written paper. Okay, now that changes takes place, that changes is said to be physical change. You have a long meter or 5 meter of cloth. With the help of the scissor you can able to cut the cloth into two pieces. Before that it will be a 5 meter. After cutting the cloth it will become a 3 meter and 2 meter. So the changes takes place, that changes are comes under physical change. Clear children? See here, chemical changes. The first one is iron rusting. On exposure of iron, Fe, after a period of time, it will get rust. Okay, so all the iron instruments, iron particles, all the iron particles became rust. So due to the atmospheric oxygen. So oxygen plays a vital role on the rusting of iron. For that only in our house we are painting the iron windows, iron rods. Okay. So next one is burning wood. If we burn a piece of wood, it will produce a smoke. The fire takes place and it produces smoke. And then metabolism. Metabolism is nothing but a chemical reaction which takes place inside the body. Okay, so digestion of food substances, so also comes under metabolism. If we are eating a solid food substances, after a period of time, that means after 2 hours, all the digested foods are digested and it becomes mixed in the blood. Okay, so once we are eating the solid food, after 2 hours it will become a digestible substances. So this reaction is called metabolic reaction. So this is also one of the chemical changes which takes place inside the body. The next one is cooking food items. Next, baking a cake. Then electroplating. Then roasting banana. Then vinegar and baking soda mixer. Firewoods, chemical battery. All these are some of the examples of chemical changes. Clear, children? So in this lesson, we will study about chemical changes, factors determining chemical changes, and the effect of chemical changes in detail. Shall we move on to the next slide? Yes. So first one is chemical changes. A chemical change is a permanent and irreversible change. Chemical change is nothing but it is a permanent change. Once it changes into a product, it will not come to the initial stage, original state. Okay. So chemical change is a permanent and irreversible change which produce a new substance. Chemical changes are otherwise called as chemical reactions. So chemical changes, all the chemical changes are said to be chemical reactions because one or more substance undergo a reaction to form one or more new substance. So one or more substance undergo reaction. The substance which undergo reaction is called reactant. Once again, I'm repeating. If any substance will undergo a reaction is called reactant. If any substance became a new substance means it is said to be product. So reactant is converted into product. So reactant on chemical changes, it will produce, it will convert into product. Once it became product, it will not come to the original state. That is called a chemical change. So chemical change is a permanent and irreversible change. See here, reactant, the substance which undergoes chemical reaction. This is called reactant. A new substance which is produced, that is called a product. Clear, children? Factors determining chemical changes. Chemical changes will not occur at all conditions. For a chemical change to take place, certain specific conditions are required. Chemical changes can take place in following conditions. The first one is contact in physical state, solution of reactants, electricity, heat, light, and catalyst. So these are all the following conditions for chemical changes. So chemical changes will not occur at all the conditions. So they have some following conditions. The first one is contact in physical state. Second one is solution of reactants. Third one is electricity. Fourth one is heat. Fifth one is light. And the last one is catalyst. So first one, contact in physical state. What is meant by a physical state, children? Can you guess? Any idea? Yes, naturally occurring state. So physical state is nothing but naturally occurring state. Clear? Yes. We experience many events in our day-to-day life. Before I said the conversion of milk into curd, that is also one of the reaction, that is one of the event we are often seeing. Okay, many events. Burning of matchstick on rubbing. Burning of matchstick on rubbing on the side, iron materials turning into reddish brown. So these are all the many changes, many events we often seeing in our day-to-day life. Why and how these changes happen? Can you guess why it happens? These changes are due to chemical reactions. So all these changes, so burning of matchstick on rubbing and iron materials turning into reddish brown, that is rust. So all these changes are takes place due to chemical reaction by contact in physical state. Combination of reactants. As I said earlier, reactants is nothing but if any substance which undergo reaction is called reactant. Clear, children? Yes. Combination of reactants in their naturally occurring state. Naturally occurring state is nothing but physical state. Okay. So combination of reactants in their naturally occurring state is referred to as physical contact. So naturally occurring state means it may be a solid state or it may be a liquid state or it may be a gaseous state. So all these are naturally occurring states. If any combinations happens, combination of reactants in their naturally occurring state is referred to as physical contact. Clear, children? See here, see the picture here. When dry wood, this is a dry wood, comes in contact with fire, okay, what will happen? The dry wood starts burning. Can you see the picture here, children? It is visible for you? Yes. So this dry wood comes in contact with some fire. Okay, what will happen? Automatically the wood starts fire, it burns with the help of oxygen in the atmosphere, with the help of oxygen to form carbon dioxide. This fire will produce carbon dioxide which given out as a smoke. Along with fire, this particular wood produce carbon dioxide as a smoke. This carbon dioxide, again it mixed in the atmosphere. Okay. Second, when a matchstick is rubbed on the sides, one person is rubbing the matchsticks on the sides, what will happen? A chemical reaction takes place to form heat, light and smoke. Okay. Third example, when quicklime, the quicklime other name calcium oxide, CaO, calcium oxide. When quicklime calcium oxide comes in contact with water, so quicklime comes contact with water. Water means normal, it is physical state, it is a liquid state. Okay, water, it forms salted lime. Salted lime is nothing but calcium hydroxide. Okay, so when quicklime contact with water to form a salted lime. See here, this is a beaker. In this beaker, some amount of quicklime. On pouring some amount of water in the beaker, so the water reacts with the reactant quicklime to form the salted lime. Can you get it? Yes. So the quicklime reacts with water. I am taking a beaker, 500 ml beaker. So with little amount of quicklime, that is calcium oxide. After that I am pouring some amount, that means 10 ml or 15 ml of water. Then what will happen? When water reacts with calcium oxide to form calcium hydroxide, that is called the salted lime. From above reactions we can conclude that, what we conclude? Certain chemical reactions takes place only when the reactants are brought in contact. Only the reactants are brought in contact with each other. See here, the chemical reactions takes place only when the reactants are brought in contact with each other in their physical state. So normal physical state, the chemical reaction takes place. How? Only when the reactants, what are the reactants here? quick lime is a reactant and then water is a reactants. Okay, so these are combined, okay, to form a product. So these reactants are brought in contact with their physical state to form a product called salicylic lime. Can you get my point, children? Yes. The next one is solution of reactants. You know very well, reactants is nothing but, what is reactants? If any substance which undergoes chemical reaction is called reactants. You should not forget this. Reactants means any substance will undergo chemical reaction is called reactants. Clear? So, what is the meaning of solution of reactants? We have to take reactants as a liquid solution. So, reaction, solution of reactants. When milk is mixed with coffee decoction, have you seen this in the home? Our mummy, what they are doing? She pouring some amount of milk in the coffee decoction. Then finally we are getting coffee. By a nice coffee, right? Everyone likes to drink coffee in the morning, right? Yes. So milk is mixed with coffee decoction. The color of the milk and the decoction changes. Initially, the decoction is in very dark color, dark brown color. Once we are adding the white milk color in that coffee decoction, it becomes a pale brown. Can you get my point? Yes. The changes takes place. So by adding a small amount of, little amount of milk in the coffee decoction, the color changes. See here, milk is mixed with coffee decoction. The color of the milk and the decoction changes due to chemical reaction. Okay. See here, similarly, when we mix two substances, whatever it may be, two substances in a solution form, that means a liquid form, the chemical reaction takes place to form a new substance. That is called the product. Okay. For example, take small amount of solid, see here, solid silver nitrate and sodium chloride, NaCl, in a test tube. Do you observe any changes, children? No. Why? So the reactants is in solid states. Okay. So no, the reactants in solid state have no reaction at all. If it may be a liquid state, means it undergoes some chemical changes. Clear, children? Now we discuss the same thing. So we discuss the same, dissolve the same reactants in water. It separate in separate test tube, both the solutions have to mix. What will happen? What we are observe, silver nitrate solution, this is a reactant, silver nitrate solution react with sodium chloride. Silver nitrate is also one of the reactant, sodium chloride is also one of the reactants. Both are in solution form, that is in liquid form, to form a white precipitate silver chloride and sodium nitrate solution. So this chemical changes takes place only in the solution form. See here, the reactant silver nitrate is in solution form, reacts with sodium chloride. This is the sodium chloride, NaCl, it is also in solution form. These two reactants are mixed. It undergoes chemical changes to form a white precipitate called silver chloride and the formation of sodium nitrate solution. So all finally we are concluded that some chemical reactions proceed only in solution form, not in the solid form. Clear, children? Next we move on to electricity. Electricity is very essential for our life. Without current, without electricity, we cannot able to live. Without cell phone, we cannot able to live. Without charging the cell phone also, we cannot able to live. Right? So, by using electricity, we use for cooking, for charging our cell phones, lighting, grinding, watching TV, laptops, computers, water heater, etc. So all this need electricity. Without electricity, no process takes place. Cooking, lighting, grinding, watching TV, charging our mobile phones, nothing takes place. Okay. So do you know electricity can be used to carry out chemical reaction? Do you know? Yes. Many chemical reactions which takes place with the help of electricity current are industrially very important. As you know, water is made up of hydrogen and oxygen. You know very well. In the last lesson, previous lesson also we discussed. So water is a combination of hydrogen and oxygen molecules. Clear? Yes. When electricity means current. When electricity, current is passed through water containing small amount of sulfuric acid. So water containing small amount of sulfuric acid, H2SO4. So water containing containing sulfuric acid, when current is passed, what will happen? The chemical reaction takes place. Hydrogen and oxygen gases are liberated. Okay. Similarly, a concentrated solution of sodium chloride, it is called as brine, is electrolyzed. Electrolyzed means by supplying current to produce chlorine and hydrogen gases along with sodium hydroxide. This is very important reaction to produce chlorine industrially. Chlorine is very essential chemical for, it is a disinfectant. Okay. So from the above two reactions, we concluded that some chemical reactions proceed only by the passage of electricity. Clear, children? Hence, such reactions are called as electrochemical. Electro, the name itself, you have the meaning. Electro, by supply of electricity. Electrochemical reactions, also called as electrolysis. Clear? The next one is eat. Food is very important for our survival, right? Without food, we cannot live. Yes? In the morning, without taking breakfast, you cannot able to listen the class, you cannot able to see the mobile phone, whatever it may be. Our body activities all is fully, mainly depends on the food. From the food, we are getting energy, right? So food is very important for our survival and also for the survival of many other living beings. That means many other organisms. Have you closely watched mother cooking food? She boils rice, she cooks vegetables, she prepares gravy by heating them over stove. What will happen? Some chemical reactions takes place, right? So when enough eating is given to some some chemical reactions takes place to convert the raw food into the food cooked one. Okay, by supplying heat, the raw food is changed into a cooked food. Okay, you can learn more about this by conducting a reaction in your laboratory. See the picture here. Take small amount of lead nitrate. So this is a burner. This is a burner and this is test tube and this is test tube holder. Okay, I am taking a small amount of lead nitrate in the test tube and it shows in the fire. It gives some heat. Okay, see here. Take small amount of lead nitrate in a dry test tube without any water in it. Dry test tube. And heat gently over a flame. I am heating this test tube containing lead nitrate over a flame. observe the changes closely, what will happen? We will hear some cracking sound and an evolution of reddish brown colored gas. So this is the reddish brown color gas is evolved. That reddish brown color gas is called nitrogen dioxide. On heating the silver nitrate, we are getting the cracking sound along with that by the liberation of nitrogen dioxide. Clear, children? Yes. In industries, limestone rocks are heated with very high temperature to get quick lime, that is calcium oxide. Hence, some of the chemical reactions takes place, can be achieved by supply of heat only. These reactions are called as thermo. Thermo means heat. Thermochemical reaction or thermolysis. On supply of heat, the reaction is said to be thermochemical reaction or thermolysis. Thank you, children. We will see tomorrow.